the reason that the huge growth in hatting that's happened all over the rest of the Northern Hemisphere has not happened in Scotland is not because of these kind of small wartime hutting sites, although most of them have been evicted, turned into caravan sites, gentrified, and otherwise got rid of. It's because the huge growth in every other country was not in more sites like this. It was individual huts sited in beautiful locations, where you want them to be, in woodland, not in serried ranks like Butlins beside one another, which is what the whole British people have actually been made to settle for. And I don't mean that lightly. The idea of camps was actually built into legislation in 1939 to cope with the Holidays with Pay Act and the idea that the unwashed would basically start swarming around middle-class holiday resorts. At that point, there was going to be permission for councils to be able to fund camps to put people in. And of course, Butlins came to the rescue, opened his camp, and the rest was history. We got camps, not camping, and we got some small hutting sites, not the ability to have that hut away out somewhere, which is what the huge growth in hutting has been everywhere else. And that's what meant that hutting has just remained looking like an insecure, dodgy, stressful, working class thing to do. And there's nothing wrong with all of those things. But the middle classes want more than that for their holidays. They want to have something beautiful, and they get it now by renting something for a week that belongs to someone else, and that's as good as anybody expects they're going to get. So that's where we've got to. The final thing to say is that procedure means that the kind of holiday homes we have in Scotland are almost the wrong leaves on the line. They're not huts. They're proper houses that should be occupied by a local person. But because it's not possible to get land to put anything on, not a first home, hardly a second home, you're not going to pay the amount of money that it takes to get land in this country and put a humble hut on it, because you just wouldn't be able to finance it, and you wouldn't get it because the land is unavailable in the first place. So all of those barriers are sitting between us and the kind of easy, lovely, sociable, restorative, reconnecting with nature that everybody else gets at our latitude. And at the same time, what is the second home in Scotland is usurping rural Scots from the homes that they, the existing housing stock that they ought to be able to access. So for all those reasons, I would love to see a hutting revolution in Scotland. But by gum, that's what it would take, because we would need to have different forests, different woodlands. They would have to be not cellulose factories. They would have to be open and available. And Andy has done the research on this, is the prime researcher on this subject himself. But again, we have no idea how weird our forestry is. And huts sit in forests. So the fact that they're generally locked up at the end of play every day means you can't have huts in them. All of these things would have to change for us to have the everyday experience that everyone else has at a wooded latitude like ours.